down here. All right, now welcome everybody to the Bag and Bin. I think I've been given the role of introducing people. I've no idea. I have no control. Let's have Jacobus. Come on out here.
How's it going? I had to add you in first after your amazing introduction.
Okay.
I'm going to leave this picture up as well for as long as I can.
The funny thing is, it looks nothing like me.
Oh, no, it does. It does.
I took a photo of myself, trying to get as boss eyed as I could, and then added that. And this is what came up.
All right. We're going to add in. Do we add in the hairiest people we've got, or do we add in the person that
Love DL? Whoa, that's hard. I mean, I would say there's a few hairy people out there, isn't there?
There is.
Let's not have hard and hairy in the same sentence. Let's bring out Dave.
Neither hard nor hairy.
Wake up, Dave!
How's it going? And that was fucking terrifying. That was a great way to start the show. I feel bad for Derek waking up to that in the morning. He's killing me.
She laughed her head off when she saw that.
How's it going? I'm dressed up. You see, one of our guests was dressed up nicely. I can't be the worst dressed person on the show. So,
wow. I will bring in the person that's clearly pulling that hat off a lot better than you. But I'm going to have to bring in the hairy duo first.
Oh, synchronized hair swishing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He has practiced that.
That wasn't too over the top, was it?
Not as much as my video.
So
can we take that down now, please?
Well, that's our intro now, permanently.
Yeah.
You'll have to do us another song if you want it changed.
I've got another one, but it's not me. But it's on my phone, so I'll have to transfer it to my computer first.
All right, so as we were saying, if you think Dave's looks ridiculous in that hat, this is how you're supposed to wear it.
Wait, that was really, really, really disturbing. Look at his face. Jesus Christ.
It recognizes where the mouth is, but because I've got my teeth like this in the original, it's like overextended that. It's
that was very disturbing.
It was one of
just
a kind
of Halloween.
It can't get worse. Surely.
Yeah.
Just wait until next week.
And let's bring in our final guest. We have... I'm going to have to move this because everyone's tiny now.
Here we go.
Hello,
hey.
Everyone.
Hello. I've never been tiny before.
Give it a chance, mate. You might like it.
But if they say that, they're all the women.
Ross, how's it going?
Yeah, not bad. Yeah, very good.
Oh, well, hold on. We're going to have to sort this out straight away. We need a nickname for Ross, and we need a name for Ross.
Yeah, because I'm, yeah. so that I don't jump in, because I can't hear properly.
I like Bamfylde. We'll call him Bamfylde.
Call me Bamfylde, yeah, everyone does.
Yeah, that's fine. Ross.
Yeah, but everyone say Bamfylde slightly differently.
Bamfylde.
There you go.
Yeah. All right.
I'm Bamfylde.
Very good.
Right. Before we get into what we're doing today, I'm going to have a gander at the chat. And is that Bab Ross? That picture thumbnail of you as delighted me today. It was brilliant.
that's new Sizzly work. She's the artist behind Bad Ross.
Is that the character we're drawing tonight from Demon Visera? One day, you're going to have to draw. All of us just sit here and draw Dave.
I'll be your muse. I'm a lot of people's muse.
Get your kit off.
Don't.
Nope.
King Pinard, did Dave eat Bob Ross? Did you,
not
Dave?
Not one bite.
No. His afro got stuck in my teeth, you see.
As long as it is his afro.
From his head.
Bushy.
I have Commie Mark saying the main CG UK is never late. I wouldn't know. It's not very often I get around to watching it because, you know, being in the best one.
I mean, why would you?
It's tough, man. It's tough. Like, perfection is hard to duplicate, you see. So when you watch our show and you go back to theirs, it's like, man. Dave,
you can't say that when you're trying to copy Russ's hat. Like,
yeah, but I upgraded.
It's got a scarf. It's just a little different.
I'm fancy.
I guess you get what you pay for. Huh? That is
true.
Good coming from a communist.
You get what you pay for, mate. I'm telling you.
You get what your comrades pay for, I think.
Yeah.
Do commies pay for everything? Or they just share what everyone else has?
They just gas up bins and shit.
Shane O'Sullivan is here. We have Michael McCartney here. King Panart is here. I've been through that. Demon Visorak. Porky Blinders. What a guy.
Very good.
Incoming copyright strike. I'm guessing that's from Rob's amazing intro, and I can tell you now it was worth it.
I was thinking maybe I should actually lip sync, like actually sing the Alan Partridge version. Don't you wish your girlfriend was hot like me? Aha!
You sing whatever faces, you think, I guess, sing, Rob.
All right, Rob, we'll put you to bed after this, mate. You're all good.
Bamfylde's over now. This has gone. Fuck this. I'm gone. I'm not hanging around for this bunch of nutters.
Are we going to be drawing Rob's goofy expression?
Goofy expression. That's his face, Shane. That's really rude.
That's his come here eyes, that is. right, so what are we doing today? The main thing we're doing today is draw along, having Russ Leach as our tutor, teacher.
Hello.
Bamfylde is back.
Sorry about that. My finger slipped again.
It's all good.
Sorry, that's a joke in itself, isn't it?
Nice. That was cutting. No, shut up, Rob. Nice. Oh, what a
piece of perfection.
Hold on. That's
I got the eyes, though.
Oh. There you go. Signed as well. Who wants it? 50 quid. Come on. Cheap. All right. I'll take a quid.
I'm sure they're lying.
The whole file. You can do what you want. Anyone? No one? Fine.
Right, so first things first, because as always, I am massively unprepared. People are, I'm just going to keep talking slowly until pages load.
Keep talking slowly.
So what are we doing tonight?
I think I'm a dead air, to be honest.
That's a genuine question because Rob didn't know.
Russ is just like, can you guys just shut the fuck up? Like, we just let it load in peace, shall we? Right, so what's everyone been doing today? Oh, you're done, are you? Okay.
I'm done. Second ages. The first thing we need to talk about.
Alright, cool. So why does Jacob says takes ages to come up? What's everyone been doing? Ah, there we go. Alright, back to it. I'm just feeling deader.
Chateu Obsidion number 3, which is our Mr. Bamfylde's baby, we'll say.
Yeah.
How are you doing with this so far?
I'm doing all right. I got £817 that I didn't have at the beginning of the campaign. You know, it did, and I only got to pay myself, so I'm doing all right with it. I'm quite happy to get as many in as for the next what will be 3 days now.
Yeah.
Want to be getting to draw some people, hopefully, get some more copies out. But it's going well. I'm quite pleased with it.
Good. So, yeah, 39 backers is pretty good, isn't it? Like, I'll be delighted.
At the 40. So close.
Sure we can, hopefully. And I seen an email update about it yesterday to say that you'd reduced prices on some stuff as well.
Yeah, some of the bigger ones, the get drawn in as a walk-on part or a recurring character, have been discounted. So has the get the original art, that's been discounted, and the custom vinyl toy of a character of your choice, that with everything else, that's been discounted as well.
So if you haven't
for the last few days, yet, a bit cheaper than it was.
Yeah, if you haven't backed them yet, and you was toying with the idea, see that little pun there for the little minute.
Hey.
Now is definitely the chance to do it, isn't it? Because you're gonna save money and help out Mr. Bamfylde. I'm trying to work out, Rob. Do you have any news for Rattle and Roll?
5 pages almost finished, or page 5 is almost finished. But I tell you what, go for the hair contingent first, and let me see if I can find something that I can share. All right.
Okay. Well, while we're waiting for Dave, for Rob to have a look at that, we'll just.
This is for the people who joined us late, right?
Yeah, sure.
I'm glad we've got this file on hand.
The fact that your lips never touch each other is quite disturbing.
It's great, isn't it?
That is really odd.
I love that.
I love it.
Right, so what's this that you're sharing?
This is the Adventure of Tales in Outer Space, which is my project now on Indiegogo. Make sure you guys sign up. We're currently in the mailing list stage. And if you sign up, you're going to be receiving free exclusive merch by legendary Mary Boys artist, Chubb. I'll show you that now. But you've all heard me give the spiel before. The Adventure Tales in Outer Space, you follow the 6-foot-tall, spandex-clad, intergalactic vigilante known as Talus. For the first time ever, you're going to receive all 4 company-released mini-comics, plus 2 awesome bonus mini-comics, including the Talus Not Daredevil crossover. So if you want to see Talus and Not Daredevil take to outer space to fight a horde of evil space Nazis and uncover the truth to the mystery, who killed Captain Fuckhead? Make sure you sign up today and stay up to date with the project. Again, massive bonus section or boner section, as insists on. where you're going to see the complete evolution of Talus, as well as every single picture I've ever drawn of him. There's that lovely artwork that you're going to receive for signing up. You'll receive it as a trading card and as a poster when you sign up. And that's courtesy of Mary Boys artist Chubb. And remember, we've got that very special 7th mini comic to unlock. As soon as we hit full funding, we'll unlock that comic, and it'll take us up to over 50 pages of Taylor's story alone. That's not including the bonus section on top of all that. So remember, that's the Adventure Taylors in Outer Space. For all of those who have signed up, keep an eye on your emails, because I'll be updating you soon with some news on what tiers are going to be on the project and different things that are going to go along with this other than the main book. So yeah, that's the Adventure of Taylor's in Outer Space. Thanks, guys. I'll throw it back to you now.
All right. Before we jump back to Rob, Sharon O'Sullivan says I took his Rob comment out of context. So repost it, and I will do it again for you, just for you.
It was something about my goofy face.
Yeah.
goofy expression. Yeah, are you going to be drawing Rob's goofy expression?
Yes.
Was that a goofy expression or a goofy impression? No. Gosh.
Graphic Goose says, I missed the start. What is Dave dressed as?
I'm dressed as Stylish Russ.
He's dressed as a market trader. I would expect him to shout about several bales of hay or fish in the next couple of minutes.
Yeah, selling lighters. Five for a pound.
Five for a pound, love. Come and get them.
Five for a pound, love. Come on.
I think you look like a proper bargain bin Doctor Who.
As we all know, the TARDIS is larger on the inside.
Yeah, but you've got to be able to get through the door first.
And
Dave Bristolian,
Bristolian Dave, or Dr. Bristolian Dave, who has been kind enough to post all of the Indiegogo links, and he says we need more mods because his fingers hurt, but we're not doing that yet.
Typing.
And King Panart is here. Dave, you plonker. Fully agree.
Plonker.
Fully agree. Right. Book. Russ Leach. Mr. Russ Leach. Only Death Can Save Us. Is that still funding on Indiegogo?
It's still in demand. It funded. Had a good campaign. Got. I'm just up to 221 backers now. Hopefully, I'm gonna see some new people, some new faces, and new audiences, because I'm obviously streaming with Joe now. So I'm gonna leave that up until I'm ready to put the next campaign up for book two. Which will be sometime in the summer.
Yeah, because what you're on now, like 9,302. So yeah. With that new audience, probably break the 10 grand mark.
We'll see. Okay. I'd like to. It'd be really nice to have that as a target. It's backers that I really want to break. If I could break 250 backers on that first book, it would mean I'd have a realistic chance at maybe getting to 350 on the second book. So it's just reasonable growth as I go up. But I've also got the book coming out via a distributor in floppies as well. I've got to make sure that I've got, all the best stuff in the book for the campaign and for the backers. And then it will get split up into floppies next year.
Is the floppies going like direct to consumer, or are they like...
No, it's going via a distributor. I don't know if you've heard of Indie Vault, they're run by Varian. And he has a distribution company called Liberty, and they're going direct to retailers. Awesome. And I'm going to be printing under the Arrow Comics banner. They've got a thing out at the moment. Randy Zimmerman has got a Indie Vault Revolt book, which is kind of like I hate the word anthology, but it's kind of like a portfolio piece. There's lots of original stories in there. So you've got a backup story of War from Only Death Can Save Us, which will be in there in black and white, and it'll actually appear in color in book two. But there's also going to be a whole bunch of backup stories. So book two is very likely to hit. It's going to be over 100 pages without doubt. But it's going to stay at the same price. So.
That'd be sick. Nice one, man.
Cool.
Yeah. So I see, I'm on with Joe at the moment on the Outliers project, and as soon as I've finished up with that, I'm straight onto book two, and I want that delivered in people's hands before the end of the year, so that I can actually go back to back with book three and get that out in the new year. So
That's what I like about you, Russ, man. You're a forward thinker, and this is the way. Like, you're doing your own comics. The end game is to get it out there to as many people as possible, which is exactly what you're trying to do.
Exactly. I mean, I think it was, EVS that kind of coined the whole idea of, you know, crowdfunding is the main event. It's your, you know, it's your big opening, you know, out in at the cinema or whatever, and people get the best quality, the full product. They get the best service. They get everything. Something also that's only going to be printed in a minimal amount of times, so it's special. Okay, so it's definitely a backer's product. It's something that connects you with the production of the book, and then like you get the cable network distribution there, which is your floppies, which goes out to as many people as possible, so that you can get your story out to as many people as possible. And of course, that's what's the most important thing. You're trying to tell a story to as big an audience as you can. So all you got to do is just make sure that both sets of customers are happy with what they've got. And they get the best that you can give them. So I think actually it's probably a pretty good model to be moving on with, as for us like small creators, just crowdfunding probably isn't the best model, you know, moving forward mid to long term. In the short term, I still think there's lots and lots of legs in the crowdfunding market. But in order for you to grow, you're going to need to see if you can step outside of that. I know that Clint has done that. From Sweetcast, he's doing that with
Alterna.
That's it. Thank you very much. Don't know if you jumped in there because my mind is shot and I can't remember names. He's doing that with Alterna, so it seems like a great model to be moving forward with. If you don't have the kind of audience that someone like, I don't know, like Malin or EVS has got,
yeah. Yeah,
but it's all amazing. Like you say, it's all about growth, forward thinking, and just getting the story out to as many people as possible, and giving a great product on the way. So
Malin and EVS should be looking past crowdfunding now, in my opinion.
Mm. But they are, aren't they? I mean, like EVS has got himself a warehouse or something, and you know he's already picked up other people to actually produce comics under his own banner. Yeah. So that's kind of growing, isn't it?
It is growing, but they're still crowdfunded, aren't they? It should be
Well, he's got his eBay store and all that, so as soon as he's done the crowfunding, anything extra goes on the eBay store. So
I mean, his model is slightly different because he has such a massive audience. So there's a whole different dynamic there. But if you're in, you know, if you're lower down as far as audience numbers are concerned, and actually getting out in front of people, I think you've got to think about a kind of a wider market if you possibly can. Mm. And let's face it, we all want more comics out in shops. So Liberty is looking to do a really good job and get around this whole gatekeeping environment that we have with Diamond and what have you, and get comics out there into the retail space. So it's good to be on board with that. Yeah.
I don't even think comic shops should be the target. I mean,
No.
I don't know about you guys. I've got like 8 miles to get to a comic shop. I don't go there very often.
Well, as far as I'm aware, Liberty is looking at all options.
Yeah. For me, you get your book everywhere you possibly can, to anyone. You want everyone to buy a book.
Which is what it was like when, you know, we're all a range of ages. I'm probably the oldest man in the room. But we all sort of bought, you know, books when we were younger from shops rather than just comic book shops. So, like, I got mine from newsagents and, you know, it would have been anywhere, wouldn't it? Comics were everywhere. And then when they took them out and put them in this direct market environment where it just went to comic book shops, you cut off a whole access to any new audiences because you used to have to go to the comic shop. Don't get me wrong, I love comic book shops and I would love to have my books in there. But it's got to be, in order to get more comics out to more people, and there is an audience, they will buy, obviously not in the millions that they used to, but there is an audience out there. You know, you've got to get it under people's noses, and just having them in comic book shops obviously isn't doing it. So you've got to think of outside the box.
And especially for younger readers as well. There's nothing for younger readers unless you've got the Beano, you've got the Phoenix in the UK, but what I've heard now is in the US, I don't know if it's DC or Marvel, but I heard on the net that one of them is putting their monthlies price up to $6.
Yeah,
DC. DC that is.
Yeah. And like, well, what about younger kids who maybe like have less money, less pocket money to give out every month? Okay, maybe $6 isn't that much, but you're kind of cutting off the possibility of gaining the interest in the formative years.
The problem is you've got corporates who are not interested about in making comics. Okay, yeah. If they're interested in making comics, they drop it back down to newspaper print, and they'd flood the market and get loads of people to buy them. But they're not interested in that. It used to be the case. You know, don't get it wrong. Like, you know, Marvel and DC, when they were all about comics, were all about money. They were corporates, but their business was making comics, and on the side they managed to sell the brand and sell, you know, t-shirts and mugs or whatever. Now their business is not making comics. Their primary business is the brand. Their primary business is selling t-shirts and mugs and films and all that kind of stuff. So they don't really, that it's an ancillary business. So in that case, I was speaking to a guy, I can't remember his name because I'm so shit with names. He used to edit at Malibu and at Marvel, and his story on the whole thing was he'd in order to forget a project green lit at Caliber, at Malibu, they'd say, right, okay, is this going to make money? And he'd go, yeah, this will make money. And they go, okay, well, a green light. But at Marvel, it was how much money would it make? And that's the big differential. It's all just bigger, bigger, bigger. And of course, there is an opportunity for all of us as indie creators to go out there and make a living at this, because we're not looking to make millions and billions like the big corporates. We're just looking to make enough money to keep making stories and getting them out there. So it's a real pity that Alterna has had to take to its own distribution system, because, you know, it could have gone so far with Diamond, but they no doubt in my mind they're being gatekept, they're being held back by the mainstream, and you know, those kind of books that Alterna have that are cheap, you know, like $1.99 or whatever it is, $1.99, what a fantastic price point, you know, put them out in, you know, in Target or whatever it might be, and kids will pick them up. Not all kids. It's not every kid. And yes, they are up against the digital world, but it doesn't matter. There is an audience out there.
Absolutely,
especially seeing as so much of the mainstream stuff. And I'm not just talking about comics. I'm talking about entertainment in general is rubbish. So.
All right. I need to interrupt you there, Ross.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm done. Yeah. I'm off my soapbox now. Yeah.
I started him. I started him.
He started me off.
Why has he got frog's legs?
That's my stuff. We're still on YouTube.
While Ross was venting, we neglected the chat a bit. Shane O'Sullivan asks Aria if you've ever been to Ice Comics Expo in Birmingham with Talbus.
No, I've only ever done one convention with Taylor. That was when I only done the first ever mini comic, and it wasn't even a comic convention. It was a design convention in London. So, I haven't really been able to ship it out. But as soon as Taylor comes out in the summer, plus you know, all the COVID restrictions are eased and shows are back on, I'll be taking my Taylor's Collector Edition around with me, hitting up all the cool shows.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I think we just got a glimpse into Dave's OnlyFans then.
Yeah. No, that's like premium membership, $4.99 a year.
Yeah.
Love Pigeon says to have your own website store is as the end goal, and crowdfunding is the stepping stone.
Have your own website. Yeah, do it. Make your own website.
Who's playing with tins? I'm guessing that's related to, I don't know if it happened to you guys, but my signal kept cutting out and everyone went really laggy. I'm presuming that might just be me from the blank expression on everyone's face then. Shane says he remembers seeing Spectacular Spider-Man and Street Fighter 2 in old local newsagents back in the early 90s. but he couldn't get his parents to buy them. I remember comic books in the newsagents, and they still have them in some newsagents by me, but they're not the same because...
I remember back in the day, you'd go on holiday to any like train station or newsagents, they would have one of these circular racks just stuffed with, you know, DC and Marvel. And it doesn't matter that you couldn't get them. You couldn't get them in like one run. You would just get what you were interested in, whatever. Mm-hmm. And it was great. I mean, I had like loads of different comics from different stories, but you kind of pick up what's going on, right? So... I mean, and that's a shame that that kind of thing doesn't exist now.
The other thing is the art of writing it in episodic content where you're happy to just pick up one issue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. But I heard that now, like, newsagents generally don't stock them because they don't bring enough revenue in. So it's just like they say they're losing money if they have comics on the on the rack, which is a shame.
Yeah.
Well, it certainly is and half the reason for that is because they were removed from the rack 30 years ago and so are not a commonplace item anymore. There's a lot of kids just haven't got a clue what a comic is.
Yeah, yeah. 2000 AD gets put on the top rack.
Yeah.
what's that all about?
Damon's hit the nail on the head where young audiences are reading digital stuff.
Okay. Kids are fucking idiots anyway.
And there's our younger audience switching off.
No, all right. Let me refrain. Most kids. I was fucking idiot when I was a kid. Not to your holding. Yes, comics.
Good day, yes, good day, Dean. Webtoons will be the future of comics. That's not frog legs. That's double impressive, Dave.
Impressive. Wow.
Bristolian Dave says, what are we drawing today? Yes, let's crack on with some.
My way of, I got to keep the show on track, you see. Otherwise, these guys were just talking.
Nice segue.
I'm the guidance. I'm that shining star that you follow to Bethlehem. That's me.
He's big Dave in the sky.
Right, last comment before we jump on.
Big fucking star, isn't it?
Marvel, DC, collectible comics don't count compared to 2000 AD. Even as anthologies, they are pricey. Could never sell them in my last job.
It's really not saying it's glowing.
And forget webtoons. Manga is the future.
Bitch.
From what I've seen, that is taking over. Right, Ross, without having a breakdown about Marvel and DC, would you be able to let us know what we are drawing today or what we are trying to draw today?
So, are you talking to me?
Yes, your name is Ross.
Are we still on Bamfylde?
Yeah.
Bamfylde. Yeah. We're still on Bamfylde. Right, so you were talking to me. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. What do you want me to draw? I don't know. What did you want me to draw?
Basically,
Dave.
Sorry. Who's talking? Jake. Go on, Jake. You host it. Go on, mate. Go on. Fuck it. I'll do it. Make up your mind. Come on. You explain. Someone explain. What's going on?
I think it's internet lagging.
A minute. I'm getting too sassy. Come on. Let's go on.
Dave, Rob, you tell us what's going on.
Okay, draw something from Only Death Can Save Us.
Right, okay. That was easy, wasn't it?
Yeah. And then we got to try and sort of follow you along.
Okay, all right. Dave, so I need to share my screen.
Honestly, I don't do everything. It's fucking Dave. It's hat. No, I got
high five.
I'm sorry.
Okay, so join us next week when we'll finally draw something from Only Death Can Save Us.
Yeah.
Okay. There we
go. Right, my paper don't look like that, so I'm going to do with what I got.
Yeah, you just do whatever you got. Sorry, sizes and shapes will be different for everybody.
Mine's slimmer, but longer.
Let's go, boys.
I feel like I've got like multiple personality disorder or something. I get dressed up fancy and I become like Darren Day. Right, so I'll comment it. Okay.
Do you want to do the Rolf Harris like ding 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 ding? Can you tell what it is yet?
So I got. So what is this? Death? No, death. Yeah.
Death. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What I'll do is I'll start again. We'll make it nice and easy for people to follow along. Okay.
Yes. Yes, please. Yeah,
right. Okay.
Please and thank you.
So what I'll do is I'll just
do my level of drawing, man. You know what you're gonna get from me. So
I'll just do his head. How's that? And that will make it a little bit easier.
Let's do that. That's what we did with TLS.
Yeah.
I feel like we should be more like sort of prepared on these things. So
would be. Yeah.
Oh, we're going already. Oh.
Yeah.
And I'm not used to drawing digitally, so don't judge me. Oh, fuck shit balls. Don't judge me too hard.
Don't judge me. Oh, fuck shit balls.
There we go. Nope. Oh, there we go.
Right, Ross. I can't look at StreamYards and Studio Pro, so you're gonna have to talk me through this.
Ahead. Yeah, I don't know quite why I have to talk you through.
Ross, last time we played this, we got stuck on draw a circle. So take it slow.
Right. Okay. So I'm looking at Death's head, or D, as he's known by Chrissy in the book.
Isn't Death's head another character?
Yeah.
So it's and the characterization is that although he's got a head that looks very much like a human skull, in the story, it's completely coincidental to his character. So I'm looking at it from, I suppose, sort of a little bit of an isometric view. So it's just, you can see it's just slightly on top.
I'll be honest, I don't know what isometric means.
Okay. So a little bit from over the top of the view. So you're not looking at it flat on, sort of like three quarters.
Oh, okay.
Dave doesn't know what three quarters is either.
No, I only go the full thing, mate. It's not...
Yeah, Dave got in there before I could say it.
Just picture it as 3 1-quarter pounder burgers, Dave.
That's harsh.
Can we just play nicely? Yeah. Just one night. Just one week.
I had a KFC earlier, man. I'm feeling it. Oh, I was doing well.
So it's although it's similar to a human skull, it's actually sort of supposed to be biomechanical. In the areas where the eye sockets are that are black, he still has a set of what seems to be eyes that have eyelids, because that makes it easier to create character and to create emotion within the black of the eye sockets. Then the other thing you do is the eyebrows, or the forehead area, is a little bit extended over the top, more than a skull would be. The idea of that again is to help out with characterization and emotional conveying emotional responses. And this bit up here, which is usually where you that bit kind of joins to the skull, is optional. I just play with that. Comes and goes. The skull itself is a little bit flattened off, and then when I'm drawing it in a smaller panel, sometimes I even sort of square the edges as well, make a straighter lines for a little bit of styling. You can see you've got that center line there. He's got almost like the sort of flat fangs, and you can just see the side of this. What's going on in there in his chin is actually something that we might see in the second book, is there is actually a chin in there, but because it's within his hood, you can't really see what's going on. So he's got the hood there. So all this would be
in the hood.
Yeah, so all this would be black in there. So all that you end up seeing is like little hints of potential technology in there, in the shadow.
That's cool.
And that will have more relevance in the second book. You'll find out just that little bit more. Actually, it's looking like the way the story's going now that there's going to be even more relevance to the technology aspect of it when we go into books 4, 5, and 6.
You can see the proficiency that Ross has with his digital art. The lines you're making are so clean, and I really struggle with
it. It's absolutely crazy. Like, that's why I respect artists so much. Like, I don't know how you guys manage to do all this. It's just...
Well, the great thing about the doing things digitally is how clean they are, exactly as you were saying, but also just the fact that you can control Z, you can rub stuff out really easily. There's no mess. I pretty much penciled exactly the same as I would pencil on a board or a light box. It's just that the layers are effectively the light boxing. And when you do things like, say you draw a panel on a page, and it's a great drawing, it really works, but it's too big. So you need to go away, photocopy it, take it down in size or blow it up or whatever, put it back on your light box, build it into the page. Well, that's layers, effectively. If you're drawing things traditionally, you should always make sure and check them in a mirror as well. And you can see, you can see where things are going a little bit awry. But of course, that's nice and easy digitally. You don't have to wait until you finish drawing the bloody thing. You can do it on the fly like this. But then once you go to inks, what I did with the inks on this was I was really scratching an itch because I wanted to do sort of very clean inks on the first book. But I'm looking at, by the time I get to the third book, that all the inks will probably be traditional. So I'll be penciling.
That's cool.
I'll be penciling digitally, printing them out, and then doing digitally traditional inks over the top.
How's that going to work? Influence your workflow? It's going to slow you down quite a bit, isn't it?
Well, what I'm practicing at the moment, actually, and it's looking like the whole of the Outliers book is going to be traditional inks. So, what I'm going to try and do is cut down on my penciling. And do more with my inks, but you're right. There is that problem, but we'll see where that goes. So certainly, the second book will be a combination. The first book I did have a few pages, four tiers that were traditionally inked, and I learned a lot out of that. So I'll be bringing that to the next book.
I know you've. You've had quite a history of drawing, hey? For the audience, do you want to mention what else you've worked on in the past?
Yeah, I got my first submission to Marvel out in about 1995, and they liked what they saw, but unfortunately I didn't get any work off them, and I had to go and pay my mortgage and have a proper job. So I did that for quite some time, had my business, did production, publishing, all kinds of stuff. And then in 2010, I decided when the business finished in a natural way, I decided I was going to give drawing comics a go, right. Which is a bit naive, to be perfectly honest. And so I started doing it then. I did some underground comics. I did some indies in the States. So a guy called... JD Rosario for Unstoppable Comics, and I learned a lot doing that, actually. And then I finally picked up a gig doing Doctor Who for Panini, in about 2015. And via that, I got a gig doing Ben 10 for Cartoon Network. And I also did an art book for Marvel called Draw the Marvel Way. And I did that for 4 years.
I've got that. It's a beautiful piece of work, mate.
Thank you. And after that, I was doing storyboarding for film. And then the COOF turned up, which just so happened to happen at the same time as I was really... Oops.
The COOF?
The COOF. The COOF.
What's the COOF? The whole COOF and nothing but the COOF?
The COOF is what's keeping us indoors.
I saw.
And
I've never heard that expression.
That's all right, have you not?
Well, been living under a rock for the past year.
Since I came back to Germany last year, like I've been at home all the time. Like I came back to Germany, and it was the 18th of March 2020, and I was back home visiting my parents, and I had to cut my trip short, you know, because Germany had just closed borders with Austria and France. So I'm like, well, bugger, if I don't now, then there's a possibility I might be locked out, you know. So and that was the 18th of March to 2020, and I've been practically at home ever since. Like all my work's at home. Anyway, we were talking about Russ.
Anyway, the COOF got me. Effectively, the COOF got all my bloody clients. So I'm still waiting on the final scenes for doing the storyboarding for the film I was involved with.
Can you tell us what it was?
It's a film called Noontide, and it's kind of like a fantasy. It's about the underworld. It's a love story, effectively. And that was quite good fun, and I'm hoping to finish off those scenes for them at some point in the near future. So I was that all fell down, and I was already in the process of I'd already penned the story for the book. So I just took the opportunity and went and did it, really. So that's where I am now.
Right, cool.
There you go. There he is.
Well, I am not impressed at how amazing yours looks. like Down syndrome-y mine looks.
You should look at mine.
No, yours. I can see yours already, and it is way better than mine.
Mine looks like an alien.
So,
they're kind of supposed to look like an alien, aren't they?
For all you wonderful viewers, take a mental snapshot of Russ's version of death. We're going to have a look at Dave's version of death.
If you want it for your book, mate, for a fan art section,
you know what? It's got a certain charm to it.
It's got a je ne sais quoi.
Yeah, I could see it with a flat cap on.
I even did highlights in what looks like felt tip.
Nice lighting. I like it.
I have my retarded version of Only Death Can Save Us.
It looks like a monkey. Good though. I like it.
That's all right. You've got all the bits in the right place.
Yeah. Oh, I don't know about that.
Eric Morecambe said
sent mine you've got to all Jack the right. Us.
You've got all the right bits, but not necessarily in the right order.
I
get told that as well. Apparently, foreplay is supposed to come first.
Go on, need wants to show you his. She's done a good job.
Can you even see it?
If I can't see
it. Hold on, I'll put you on big screen.
It's all blown out. Yeah.
Take a picture, send it.
Put her on big screen. Put her on big screen.
She's on big screen.
I am on big screen.
What are you watching me?
I'm just
going on some paper.
My camera like really washes us out.
Yeah, look at it. It's like,
whoa.
Yeah, I can't see that.
I'll take a picture.
Oh, that's good. Who did that?
Hey, hello.
That is Rob's.
So what I'm going to do...
I've sent mine to Jacobus on Twitter. I can't share anything, I'm afraid.
I'm watching the StreamYard and I'm trying to click my tools here. There you go.
There's Ross. Oh, my computer's so laggy.
See, I still... This is only the second time I've drawn digital. And it's like... It just feels so weird. Like, I don't...
How are you drawing? Are you drawing onto a little tablet on the desk?
Yeah, I got a tablet and then I'm looking at a separate screen.
Yeah, it's a fucking nightmare.
The amount of control Z I had to.
I draw straight onto the screen. So I've got a Cintiq that I draw straight onto.
If I was good, then I'd get something like that, but this was cheap and
I have to say that there are some options now. You don't have to buy Wacom. There are some great options out there now.
Yeah, I'm drawing on a Huion, which is the bargain version, which is fitting.
I picked up this Hanvon in China 2 years ago.
Blimey. That's nice.
Nice, yeah.
Is that Ross's?
This is Mr. Bamfylde.
Bamfylde. Nice. Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, that's amazing. Nice.
I sent you mine on Twitter as well.
That's like Graphic Goose has done one as well. He sent it to Aria. Demon's put his in the group chat. Man, see that? Everyone's doing it.
That's really cool. That's super cool.
this is one thing I like. It's like it's practically fan artwork, mate.
That sounds good.
Some better than others.
Send it to Jacobus.
But... Look, this is why I'm going for the writing side of things, because I might colour one day, because I can flat by the looks of it, you know, feel. And
flatting is I'm not going to say it's easy, because it's a laborious job.
It's a pain in the ass, is what it is.
Yeah, it's laborious. It really is. Oh, that's good.
Oh, that's cool.
It looks like he's chewing a wasp. That's great. He's like, like that.
That is Neve's version. Fine.
Oh, that's cool.
That's cool.
Oh, I've got that.
Right, okay. Did you... That bar across the bottom of his... Have you got the book? Aria.
Have I got the book?
Yeah.
No, we don't have the book.
Oh, right. Okay. This it's all right. No pressure. I noticed that there was a bar across the bottom of his neck piece there, which is actually the way that he's drawn in the book. I was just wondering if there was a...
That was neither there.
Yeah, I just wondered if it was subliminal there, because I had not put that in my drawing. So.
I didn't even know the character, so I just...
No. It's an obvious thing to do then. no originality points for me.
I'm sharing mine now.
Oh, look at that. Fists as well. Like it.
Cool. Oh, yeah. Good.
Well,
yeah.
All right. Mr. Show Off. I could have put legs on mine. Didn't want to.
They don't look like frogs' legs.
That's sick. I like that, man. That's cool.
Yeah, that is cool. You can really tell who are the artists and who aren't, can't you?
Can you?
Yeah, you can, Dave. Oh. It's not looking for it.
I'm not going to accept that audio. Yeah, you can.
Well, Graphic Goose sent you one Aria. Well done. The one he did.
I've got Demon. Ross, if you didn't see the Taylor's draw along, Demon Vizorak sent in the most phenomenal demon version of Taylor's.
Excellent.
And I'm digging, it's only death can save us.
That's cool. I like that. I like Glyn in Monsterland's comment. That dude is actually more scary. I think it's... That's good.
Wow.
All right, was I forwarded one? Did you say Aria? What's that? Oh, yeah. Oh shit, this one's gold as well.
It's really cool.
Oh, that's good.
Good.
Yeah. That was Goose, yeah?
Yeah.
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 He's got skills, man.
Yeah, my my favorite part of these is seeing what the chat come out with as well.
Yeah. The fact that the chat are drawing along as well, I think that's brilliant. What a great concept.
Yeah, it's,
told you, we're the best UK show, man. Just
good, good audience participation. That's what these streams are all about.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for Commie Mark to get his.
Like, yeah, that's yours, mean Phil.
But he's maybe I might have to try Trudy one time. I don't know.
So yeah, I was just thinking that myself. I might the next time I might try pencil and paper so I don't have to quit flicking.
Yeah.
I found it a lot easier on paper, to be honest.
Did you? Sharing it wasn't as easy, but
no.
That's easily workaroundable.
That's a word.
Right. It is surely workaroundable. Makes sense in my head.
You put a ball on the end of anything, I suppose it works.
Yeah. Except maybe a ball.
Bristolianable.
Bristolianable, yeah. Mm. Although Bristol is a bit of a funny place at the moment, I'll have.
Yeah.
All that shit that went down last night. All you fuckers that burnt that police car and the van and damaged that building. Fuck you.
You're dystopian, Dave, now, aren't you?
It's not going to help, is it?
No. You don't want that bill to go through. It's tough shit. You're all anarchists. Fuck off. In the nicest way possible.
You should have gone down the address like, ah, Dave, no one would have messed with you.
Oi, that hat and scarf.
Get away from that fucking horse.
There's some fucking geezer from London. Have him.
Is he driving a Reliant Robin?
Stato has joined us in the chat. Hello, Stato.
What's the Superman for? Very proud.
David well on his way.
I will have that.
That's the nicest thing that's been said to you today, isn't it?
Yeah. I know. Honestly. That's why I like Stato, man. Positivity always. But I still hold it against him for not putting Cyborg at the top of their list when they were doing their moves. But that'll be rectified. Don't worry. Stato's got me on that one. Van Damme. Talking Van Damme. For anyone who don't know, Jean-Claude Van Damme. Muscles from Brussels.
What about him?
They were doing a random thing. And they had, I can't remember the dude's name now. On Woolly's channel. You can check it out after. But Cyborg was one of the films. And they put it as like middling. And I'm like, no, it should have been top. I told him that, and they didn't do it.
What was that one he was in first? Was it No Retreat, No Surrender? Yeah, is that the one where he broke the sensei's leg? He broke the guy's dad's knee when he like kicked him? Yeah.
Yeah, I love. Yeah, I played a bad guy, but no,
that was great. Bloodsport. Yeah. So is Bloodsport the one with the sort of the street fighter kind of? Oh no, it's that one. Right. Okay. Time Cop. How awful that was.
Love that shit, man.
What was the one where he was? It was almost like Street Fighter. He went off to some kind of secret. There were people from all over the world there, like really.
Bloodsport. Yeah, it's Bloodsport, I think.
Bloodsport. Is that it?
One where he fights like.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking of. Yeah, no, I love that film. That's great.
Bloodsport, so honestly, it's so good.
Totally over the top.
Oh, yeah.
When we do our own version of Bloodsport, only one of us will make it out alive.
I don't know. This is what I mean. I'm overtired, man. I'm just like.
When you get yourself doing some fight training.
Hey, look, you can fight, all right? I know that. You can fight really well. 10 years ago, I would have loved to have sparred with you. Today, I'm too fat and lazy. I used to love it, man. Mixed martial arts, Muay Thai, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Olympic wrestling. Fantastic. I loved all that. And then I stopped for some reason. I can't remember why. Oh, I do. My granddad died. That was it.
Oh, right, don't say shit like that. I was about to make a funny joke and I can't now because
no, baby, no, all right, he died and then they moved where they were training and it's too far for me to get to. Go.
I was gonna say your mixed martial arts sports, sumo wrestling and hot dog eating contests weren't there.
Oh, that's harsh.
That's right. See, that's I get so bullied, crazy. Man. I got bullied. Yeah,
that is not nice.
We love you, really.
I know.
For sure.
I won't be here. Right. Fuck you guys. Love you too.
Yeah.
Wait, what's the chat saying? Everyone's saying, like, I see my name a lot. Why is all my name? Why are you talking about me?
Who better John be Denver song out there somewhere.
Just don't John pay Denver. Attention to the chat. Be nice, I promise.
West Virginia, Mountain Mom.
Oh, man. Right.
Country.
So, before we wind down and log off, because I need a cup of tea, and Dave didn't go for his pre-show shit, as he declared earlier.
KFC, man. You know how greasy that shit is.
Drop the kids off at Mr. Brown's.
It's not good.
Oh god!
Yeah. You guys, Mr. Bamfylde, Chateau Obsidion 3. Hey,
that's right. Yep. Back it now.
I was going to say, Mr. Bamfylde, Chateau Obsidion 3.
Yeah.
3 days, just 3 days. Back it now.
I know I talk a lot of shit, but you guys really need to back this book, man. It's so well priced. It's unbelievable. It's like the same price as the mainstream comics, man. Like, and. Just for that, you should take a go. But the fact is, the book looks good. You see his scenes in it, like his big open scenes, like the angles he gets on them look fantastic. And if you don't want to take a chance on the physical copies, do £3 to get the digital copies, man. What are the average? Do it.
I mean, physical copies.
Yeah, look, £13 for three issues.
Hmm.
You want to go with DC now? That's £6 an issue. That's £18. It's cheaper.
That is cheaper than the mainstream.
Yeah.
And I can almost guarantee that the story is going to be better than the mainstream nowadays.
Yeah, I think that's almost guaranteed now.
Yeah.
I'm gonna shut up and let other people talk now because I talk too much.
No, that's fine.
Oh, sorry, I'm just actually inking my death picture here at the moment.
Oh, no.
Nice.
Let me see.
Yeah, there it goes. Get the catch ripper.
Oh, man, this computer's lagging so bad. Mario was kind enough and he already shared his screen.
There we go. Let's talk about this one, guys.
Yeah, baby.
Right. So... the first ever bargain bin book is now on Indiegogo. That's Twisted Fairy Tales. So it says all in the title. That's fairy tales with a twist. So make sure you sign up today. I'm sure someone's posting the link either in the description or in the live chat. There's a book created by the Bargain Bin Show where it's gonna feature short stories, short fairy tales with a twist from all the individual Bargain Bin members. Plus, a whole bunch of other creators who have previously been unpublished, and this is just a real good way for them to get their work finally into a book, into print. So there's a whole bunch of us on here, including the Bargain Bin Show. If you head over to Jacobus's Twitter, you can find an example of the sort of artwork that's going to go into the book, the sort of story. He has a short story up pinned at the top of his Twitter for you to read. And make sure you sign up so you're staying up to date with all the various updates that we're going to be sending your way on the campaign because it's still early days. We've got a lot to tell you yet. And make sure you follow the CG UK Bargain Bin Show on Twitter. Where that's another place we'll be keeping you updated. And we're also running a competition. If you send us a 2 to 4 page story, a fairy tale with a twist, send us a DM on Twitter or via our email. That's bargainbin@gmail.com. Did I get that right? No. What's the email?
cguk@gmail.com.
Okay, listen.
Oh, God, Aria. Come on, man.
Send us an email or send us a DM, and one lucky winner will be in with a chance of having their story put and drawn into the book. So get on that, guys. Should we play the trailer?
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah.
Is it with the voices?
It's with the voices.
The Princess and the Frog.
I need to find a prince.
Maybe I could be of assistance. Don't be alarmed, my lady, for I may appear to be a frog, but I am actually a prince.
You don't look like a prince.
I was transformed by an evil witch awaiting my first kiss.
You're still a frog.
Maybe you need to relax a bit.
Nah, seriously, mate. Another princess fell for it.
Da 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 da. Boink.
So that is Twisted Fairy Tales on Indiegogo. Make sure you sign up, guys. I just seen Dave post some links in the chat. So anything else to add to this before we move on?
Only if no one objects to my sharing something from Rattle and Roll 5, Rattle and Roll 2.
Video
file. No, I don't want video file. Boom. Share screen, application window. Boom, 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 boom. So, there, am I sharing already? There you go. Rattle and Roll 2 is coming soon. Work is advancing. You can follow me on Instagram, Rob G Price Tunes. Obviously, you can follow me on Twitter, Rob G Price, and you can follow me here with the Bag and Bin crew. Let's see, what else can I say? Rattle and Roll one is obviously still available, will still be available on Amazon via Blurb and via Artith Merricks. I have a pre-launch page. I haven't sent anything out, I must admit. I'm very new to Indiegogo, but stuff coming soon.
Also, while that was happening, I got this on Twitter. Mr. Bamfylde inked.
Nice.
Paste. That's amazing.
Oh, that's cool. Wicked.
Oh, that's sick, man.
Cool.
Good. I think that's one of my favorite ones from today.
Very, very cool.
Right, so we've done everything. Book. You don't have a book. You have a book and we've done that. You have a book and we've done that. Ross, if you don't explode again and go on like an old man rant, feel free to plug your book.
Okay. All right. No shouting at parked cars. Yeah, you can find me at russleach.com, comicbookblackbelt.com. You can go find me on YouTube as Comic Book Black Belt. You'll see my process and the way that my work comes together. You can find out more about Only Death Can Save Us at onlydeathcansaveus.com. There is a link there to the Indiegogo campaign, which has fulfilled, and lots of people have got their books quite happily. But it's still in demand if you want to grab yourself a copy. Then I'll be moving on to book two sometime this year, when you can get stuff like this, where you'll be seeing some more traditional art tiers in the campaign, and hopefully some more bits and pieces. I think I'm going to go for some more magnets, actually, because people really like those. So thanks very, very much to everybody who's backed. But if you know anyone who hasn't and they fancy a piece of Bronze Age magic, go find my book in demand at onlydeathcansaveus.com.
Yeah. Aria, I've saved you till last because you didn't back Only Death Can Save Us. Yeah, wait until the end.
Right. Yeah, guys, you find me everywhere at Aria_blackness. That's Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Make sure you're going to find different content about TLS on each of them. Like on Instagram, you're going to see all the behind the scenes stuff. I can't talk. Make sure you sign up to the Adventures of TLS in Outer Space now on Indiegogo. There'll be updates coming soon, so check your emails, guys. And yeah, CGUK Bargain Bin is on Twitter. Make sure you follow us on Twitter. Neve's running the show over there, so make sure you get on it. That's where you're gonna hear first about all the various updates for this show and the book.
Ka-ching.
Dave, do you have anything?
Maybe. Okay. My YouTube channel closing in on 200 subs, getting so close, 189 now. So if you like physical media, you like comic books, you like Bristolian Dave, you like my accent, you like me, sub to my channel anyway, and you'll get some more Bristolian physical media goodness.
There was a lot of variables there.
Kingpin, I got one more insult in before we close out.
Wouldn't be right unless we got some more insults in. Thank you very much.
Fucking, oh, I love
hairline.
That.
What's that? Fucking hell.
Yeah. So make sure you sign up to Twisted Fairy Tales. Sign up to Taleless. Sign up to Rattle and Roll number 2. Sign up to Dave's OnlyFans.
$4.99 a year.
Yeah, $4.99 a year. What a bargain that is. Pay for that with money you find off the street.
Okay, so I'm gonna speak for a few weeks. Put your cup out. You get enough money to sign up to my OnlyFans. Why not?
Yeah, back Only Death Can Save Us, and definitely back Chateu Obsidion 3. If you haven't already, get the catcher up tier because it looks amazing. And in bargain bin tradition, you got to do the game wave while we log off. So, game wave.
Goodbye.
That's it, Daniel.